Mavs return their leading scorer, and we'll get a look at closer look at their team on the WAC Women's Basketball Preview Show. I'm Kendra Sheehan alongside WNBA coach Brandi Poole. And you look at UT Arlington with head coach Sharika Wright and what they were able to do last year in the tournament, but also that second half of the season.
Right. You know, they lost some key players, but I think what they bring back in Avery Brittingham and Talia Clark is a really good core for this group. And I love what Coach Wright is building there at UTA. And I look forward to them to be the X factor in the WAC this year.
All right, we'll go ahead and bring in head coach Sharika Wright. And we just talked a little bit about it, but you get three returning starters back in Avery Brittingham, Talia Clark, and Naya Three. And with those newcomers, how has this group just attacked the offseason?
Well, first of all, good morning, ladies. It's so good to see you guys again. This is always a fun part of the year. But, you know, I think one of the things that I focused on more so than anything is it's so important to bring back a core that understands your culture, your expectation, and your standards. And you talked about those three critical players with Talia Clark, Avery Brittingham, and Naya Three. They understand what the expectations are. So we're so excited about the upcoming year. We've had a great summer session, and so we're just looking forward to get moving.
Coach, talk a little bit about your newcomers and what you're seeing from them so far this year, and if there's kind of someone that has surprised you or maybe your X factor for this season.
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, the transfer portal, we dived into that a little bit. We've actually added some JUCO players as well, too, with that and some freshmen. So I think in particular, I think we all had those newcomers have been very impressive for me thus far. Their attitudes, their commitment to being, you know, successful and being great has been big for me. Their commitment to being able to push the returners has been really good. But I think more so than anything, it's been the chemistry that I've been very, very impressed with. Our players get along with each other. They can laugh and joke, but more so than anything, they understand the assignment as we talk about every single day. And so I have been very, very pleased about our newcomers and integrating them into the culture of what we have here.
You say you want to be disruptors on defense. How has that progressed through the offseason, week to week, as you lead into the season?
Well, absolutely. So, yeah, I think one of the things that me and my staff talked about was more so is on our defensive end. I thought as towards the end of the tournament, I thought we did a really good job of being disruptive. That's a big part for us. I know we can definitely score for sure, but it's more so than anything is being able to switch up our defenses, understanding again what team strengths are, and we got to be able to take those away. And so every day, I think we've had an emphasis of being able to understand what our cards are, is having the communication, being aggressive, being relentless, being disruptive, and being selfless are our cards every single day. And so when our players walk on that floor, they understand, again, what is expected of them every single day, what is the standard. And so we've been focusing on that. I've been very pleased with that thus far. And we're going to continue to work on those things until we get up to that time when we start playing.
Coach, let's talk a little bit about Avery Brittingham. She has such a unique skill set. She's got championship pedigree coming from SFA. Let's talk a little bit about her leadership and what she brings to this program.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, first and foremost, I think, you know, for me is that understanding what a player does for your program. You got to look at it from top to bottom. And for me, understanding that from Avery Brittingham, she's definitely that for us. I mean, she, you know, garners a double team. You know, we play through her. She's at the top of everybody's scout. So I think that those things are important. My challenge for her has been able to step into a different role. I thought she showed that in our WAC tournament this past season and what she can do. And she's got to continue to do that for us. It's her standard. It's her habits every single day that she knows what she'll talk about once she gets up here. But it's leading the way and it's setting the standard and the expectations every single day. And that's what she's doing thus far. You know, obviously she was picked, you know, preseason for the preseason team and rightfully so. But more so than anything, what she does for our team just garners her to be a player of the year in our conference for sure.
And Coach, we'll get a chance to talk with Avery about this, but you know that Zoe Nelson's one of her good friends from SFA. We saw her name hit the transfer portal. How much was she pushing? Hey, Coach, come on, you got to bring Zoe to UT Arlington.
She had just a little bit with that pieces of it all too. But, you know, you talk about Zoe Nelson and what she does. We love her versatility. And that was one of the things that, you know, we looked at once she entered the portal and what we felt like we were missing. And I tell you, Zoe has done an unbelievable job of coming in and adapting to what our standards and what my expectations are of hers. And so I look forward to moving her around on the floor. I mean, her ability to be able to rebound the ball, to be able to stretch the defense, and to be able to play multiple positions is what we looked at about her. So we're excited for her and AB to be able to team up again and play. But we just love, again, the chemistry that she does bring and how she blends in with the rest of this group.
And Coach, looking at, you know, your great facilities, the College Park Center, home of the WNBA Dallas Wings, we got the coach right here. How impactful has that been in terms of recruiting and getting the chance to have those recruits come in and be around WNBA pro athletes who they aspire to be?
Well, absolutely. Well, we love having Brandy and being a part of that, but more so than anything, it's great for our players to be able to see that every single day. They have been really great to us. To be able to see, you know, what they're doing, what they're growing here is big. As you talked about in recruiting, it's always great, especially for those young women who have aspirations to play at the next level. But more so that, again, front office, there's other opportunities that we get to see that it's not just about them playing on the floor. So we love the partnership that we do have with the Dallas Wings. We love our facility. We love what UTA has to offer. And so, you know, we just have a lot to offer for our student athletes and their families, and we want to continue to push that narrative.
Coach Wright, thank you so much. Best of luck this season. We'll turn it over to our player breakdown. I kind of believe it's Avery Brittingham breaking down.
It is Avery Brittingham, and there's just so much. It was hard to find just two clips for her. As the film rolls here, you see her flashing to the middle of the zone, drawing a double team that Coach talked about. She is going to find the open player. She led the team in assists, flashing back to the ball, and then if she gets the ball anywhere in the paint, she is just uber talented. And then here you go. This is what we talked about. Pause right here. As a point forward, you know, she got the ball, she rebounded and started the break up the floor. But now she's going to follow in here. She's going to direct the offense as the tape rolls. We'll see her direct. She's going to move the ball. And then she's going to come into a little pick and roll here. Pause. You see her roll out the switch here and roll to the rim. Again, she gets the ball anywhere in the paint. Avery Brittingham is going to score the basketball. Go ahead and roll the film around the rim. She's just so talented. I love her skill set. I love what she brings to the table for UT Arlington.
We saw her in WAC Vegas getting double, triple guarded, and somehow she finds a way to get that hoop in the basket. We'll go ahead and take a look at the non-conference schedule for the Mavericks. Opening at Arizona, they got Arlington Baptist. They play at Arkansas. They play at Purdue. Head coach Sharika Wright's alma mater. That's a cool one on the schedule for them. At SMU, it's a pretty big road swing they have there in the middle of the schedule.
This is one of the toughest schedules that I've seen of the WAC coaches preparing, but I think that that speaks well to what Coach Sharika Wright thinks of this team and their ability to win the WAC this year. And she's challenging them early, and I like that. I like the schedule that she's going to challenge them.
Certainly be fun to watch as we'll go ahead and bring in Avery Brittingham, the 6'1", fifth year from Fort Worth. It's her second year with the program. Avery, welcome to the show, and we'll talk a little bit about last year first, and you were still learning to play with each other at the beginning of the year, but then you clicked and you never looked back. Now you got 12 new faces on the roster. Do you feel like it's a little bit starting over again and learning to gel with each other early on in the start of the season?
Hi, how are y'all? And no, I don't really think that it's going to be difficult gelling just because we brought back so many of our core pieces. And the people who are coming in are willing to learn and willing to fill the roles that we need to be filled to be great. So I don't think that adjustment is going to be too tough for us.
Avery, you've won a championship in the WAC, so you understand what it takes. So talk about the leadership. And I love that Coach Wright talked about that you show up and work hard every day because you want your best player to be your hardest worker. So kudos to you for that. But talk about what you bring to this team.
Yeah, I just try to bring leadership in any way I can, whether that's showing the younger girls like what I know, you know, talking to them, teaching them, talking them up, even just being a positive role model to talk to, someone at an event to, anything. I just try to do whatever I can to be a leader on this team, whether that's giving people rides, just whatever I can to help, you know. That's big for me. I feel like if you get it together off the court, when you're on the court, it'll feel it which is just so easy, you know.
You get your best friend back on the roster in Zoe Nelson. What was it like bringing her to UT Arlington, and how has it been reconnecting like no time's passed?
Oh, it's been great. It's been so great. I love having Zoe here. She's such a good basketball player. She's such a good person. And, you know, she has experience winning, too, at SFA. And, you know, we just click. It's easy playing with someone you get along with really well. Yeah, we've been together basically every day since she's been here, so that's been fun too. And you know, we just act like no time has passed.
Avery, I'm going to give you a chance to brag on some of your teammates this year. You had some injuries, you had some young players last year, but who in your mind has really worked hard in this offseason and is going to surprise some people coming into this year?
Okay, well, I have a couple. So my first one would be Nia 3. Just seeing how much she's put in her bag offensively as far as scoring the ball, I feel like y'all are going to be in for a real treat with that one. My second one would be Callie Hayeslip. She's gotten so much better just from March to today. She's put in a lot of work, a lot of shots, and you can see it. And then my last one would be Jamiah Perry. She's coming off of an ACL injury. Every single day she's working, you know, so you got to give her that.
And Avery, you've really been an anchor for this team over the course of your time. They're consistent and durable. Started 80 games in your career. In the last two seasons, you've started every single game. How have you been able to stay on the floor and be so valuable every single game?
Treatment, a lot of treatment, a lot of rehab, a lot of recovery, a lot of cold tubs, Normatec boots, a lot of game ready, a lot of just recovering, getting my mind ready. A lot of film, just knowing what I can do, just knowing what I need to be better at so I can be whatever this team needs me to be.
Avery, one final question for you. You guys made a great run in WAC Vegas last year, poised to do so again. But what do you think is the one thing that is going to put you guys over the top to really make a run for this WAC championship?
Togetherness, like us playing together, us being together. You know, the basketball season is one of the longest seasons in college sports. So just staying together from November to March or April, whenever we stop playing, just being a unit, being a team.
Well, Avery, thank you so much for sharing a little bit about your team. Best of luck this season. We're going to take a quick break.